Hi everybody, I'm Emma Head, Chief Railway Officer at HS2, bringing you our latest update on the work we've been doing to build HS2. I'm delighted to be your guide on this 140-mile whistle-stop tour of the construction progress we've made during 2023. HS2 is Britain's biggest build and unprecedented in scale. We're building more than 500 bridging structures over and under the route, more than 100 embankments and about 70 cuttings, the longest stretching for 2.5 miles. As we start 2024, work is already underway on over two-thirds of HS2's viaducts and over half of our bridges. Over 25 miles of tunnels have been created by our giant tunnel boring machines. When the first HS2 service is launched, passengers will start their journey at Old Oak Common Station in West London, which will be the UK's largest new build station and will be the line's temporary southern terminus. We're into our third year of permanent construction of this vast station, and already we can see it taking shape. Over 500,000 cubic metres of London clay has been excavated to create the underground station box, and construction of the first of 14 new platforms is now underway. Once complete, Old Oak Common will integrate into the existing rail network, connecting HS2 with the Elizabeth Line, the Heathrow Express, and the Great Western Main Line. To ensure trains can flow freely and on time, as they leave Old Oak Common Station, they will pass through Victoria Road crossover box. Over 130,000 tonnes of soil have been removed to create this structure. That's the equivalent of around 55 Olympic swimming pools. This huge caterpillar-shaped structure, 128 metres in length and 25 metres deep, is approaching its final stages of construction. The western section of the box has been handed over to our tunnelling teams to become the launch chamber for two huge tunnel boring machines, Emily and Anne. The two machines will start their 3.4 mile journeys in early 2024 to dig the eastern section of Northolt Tunnel. They will join our first two London TBMs, Shoshilla and Caroline, who are already over 1 year into constructing the western section of the tunnel, with each tunnel boring machine having completed over 2 miles of their 5 mile journey so far. On the outskirts of West London, construction of the Colne Valley Viaduct has passed its halfway mark on its journey to become Britain's longest railway bridge. Over 500 deck segments have been manufactured and installed already. All of the iconic V-shaped piers are complete, and our construction team is moving forwards, assembling the 80 metre long spans that will carry the railway across the lakes. At 2.1 miles when complete, the Colne Valley Viaduct will set a record as the longest rail bridge in the UK. Yet it will take just 40 seconds for passengers to go across it once HS2 bullet style trains are in operation. And once across the viaduct, they will pass through what will be the largest single project in our Green Corridor programme, where our teams have begun creating the first of some 90 hectares of new chalk grassland, using the chalk from our tunnelling activities. They will then head into the 10-mile long Chiltern Tunnel, the longest tunnel on HS2. Florence and Cecilia, the first of our two tunnelling machines to launch, are now over 90% of the way through their journey under the Chiltern Hills and on track to complete their drives and break through at the north portal of the Chiltern Tunnel early in 2024. And as the machines edge closer to that finishing line, the expert team behind them are installing the tunnel invert, which will house the HS2 track, and constructing the 38 cross passages that link the twin tunnels together. As passengers exit the Chiltern Tunnel heading north, they will enter a network of cuttings, embankments, viaducts and green tunnels, which will support high-speed trains travelling at up to 225 miles an hour across a broad range of landscape to deliver a smooth and reliable journey. Across 2023, we made huge progress on many of the major structures that will carry HS2 trains into the heart of the West Midlands and further north. The piers for Wendover Dean Viaduct are coming out of the ground as the team prepare to launch the first sections of the low carbon deck in 2024. The first of 72 massive Lego block beams have been lifted into place for our pioneering Thames Valley Viaduct, the first of its kind in the UK to have all major elements manufactured off-site. And the designs for Small Dean Viaduct in Buckinghamshire and Edgecote Viaduct in Northamptonshire have now been unveiled. As HS2 trains enter Northamptonshire, they will travel underground in two green tunnels. Work on the 1.7 mile Great Worth Green Tunnel, the longest cut and cover or green tunnel on the HS2 route, started in 2023, with the first of 5,410 segments being lifted into place. Along with their sister tunnel, the 1.5 mile Chipping Warden Green Tunnel, these tunnels are built using an M-shaped double arch design. And much like many of the viaducts on the route, all major components are precast in a factory before being assembled on site. Once complete, the tunnels will be covered with earth and landscape to a tailored design featuring thousands of native trees and shrubs. Over 35 million cubic metres of material has been excavated across the route to create below ground cuttings to date, using a fleet of machines which are carefully tracked and monitored using an innovative real-time reporting system. Around 95% of the material excavated is reused on site to create our embankments, noise barriers and landscaping. We're moving about 99% of the material on HS2 land using a network of temporary haul roads to reduce traffic on public roads and minimise impacts for local communities. As the route enters South Warwickshire, we dip below ground again and into the Long Itchington Wood Tunnel. The second drive of the Twin Bore Tunnel, which takes HS2 under an ancient woodland, was completed in March 2023 when TBM Dorothy broke through at the south portal. After the breakthrough, Dorothy was dismantled and transported to our Bromford tunnelling site to be reused to dig the tunnel next door to where I'm standing right now. As we head north out of the tunnel, our trains will travel along cuttings and embankments through a green tunnel at Burton Green and under bridges, including the huge 5,600-ton Kenilworth Overbridge, which was moved into place under the existing Coventry to Leamington line in July 2023. This was the third major bridge move delivered over a two-week period, with structures installed at Fulham Wood near Lichfield and at nearby Streathay that will allow HS2 to pass beneath existing railway lines on its route going north, where it will connect to the existing railway network. In Solihull, a huge amount of work has been delivered over the past year to prepare the area for construction of the new HS2 interchange station, including the removal of an existing bridge over the M42 motorway, and work to improve and remodel the local road and utility networks. This will create the space to build the new eco-friendly HS2 station in the heart of Solihull, which will be part of a new public transport interchange serving Solihull and the West Midlands. Heading north out of the station, our trains will enter the Delta Junction, a triangular section of the high-speed railway made up of viaducts, embankments and other bridging structures, with around 10 kilometres of track crossing a network of motorways, roads and rivers. During 2023, we saw the first piers for the Water Orton and River Thames viaducts completed, and the first of over 2,700 individually cast deck sections from our precast factory in Kingsbury have started to be installed. And as the railway sweeps west towards Birmingham, we enter the Bromford Tunnel, where we're standing today. Over 1 kilometre of this tunnel has been completed so far, and work is underway next door to prepare a second tunnelling machine for launch in 2024. These machines will each dig around 3.5 miles of tunnel towards the western portal at Washwood Heath. From Washwood Heath, where our depot and control centre will be located, trains will head into a series of 5 connected viaducts that will carry passengers right into central Birmingham. We've made huge progress on those viaducts. The first sections of the deck have been poured that will ultimately bring high-speed trains into Birmingham's Curzon Street station. Construction works will begin at the 25-acre station site early in 2024. I hope you've enjoyed this update and seen the scale of works that we're delivering across over 350 sites between London and the West Midlands. HS2 is the biggest and most ambitious infrastructure project in the UK, and we look forward to bringing you more updates as we continue to deliver Britain's new high-speed railway. Thank you.